As we've mentioned, all of the precautions taken so far, however drastic, are meant to prevent people from being exposed to the coronavirus. Germs can rapidly spread, especially in indoor environments, as we learn from Charles Gerba, an environmental microbiologist with the University of Arizona. Keep this simple for me. What is the coronavirus?
Coronavirus, actually, there are coronaviruses that occur every year. They're part of the common cold viruses. They cause about 5 to 7% of the common colds every year in the United States, but nobody dies from it.
What makes this strand so different than previous years?
Well, I think this current coronavirus is a much higher rate of mortality. Usually with the common cold coronavirus, we have no recorded mortality. It's not as bad as the SARS agent that occurred in 2003, where the mortality rate was 10% among the general population. This new coronavirus is about 3 to 4% mortality, so it's less, but it's spreading much faster. The SARS agent that occurred in 2003 didn't survive well in the environment, thank goodness, so it wasn't as easily transmitted as this new coronavirus.
Some of the practices that many of us are undertaking, you know, reduced work hours, working from home, no more handshaking, no more gatherings of 10 or more. How effective are those measures?
Well, limiting exposure is one of the keys to preventing the movement of this virus from one person to another. For example, let me give the idea. We've done studies where we put a tracer virus on a push plate to an office building of, say, 100 people. Within 4 hours, it's on 50% of the people's hands and half the surfaces in that facility. It's quite interesting that the coffee break room seems to be the area where people not only exchange germs but also gossip at the same time, because that seems to be the first area contaminated. So separating people at work, not going to work, is a really good idea, because we've seen the viruses spread very rapidly in an office environment today.
Dr. Gerba says the novel coronavirus can survive in the air for several hours and live on surfaces for 2 to 3 days, factors that underscore the need to disinfect surfaces and keep hands sanitized, something his lab focuses on enhancing.
We're working on continuously acting disinfectants, which you would put on a surface, but any time a virus lands on it, they would start killing it right away. And that's one of the new weapons we feel in germ warfare that would be very useful. So we're rapidly working right now on all kinds of new technologies that could be used to coating surfaces to reduce the spread of viruses like the new coronavirus. And that's one of the things we're really emphasizing here.
How quickly can you take what you're doing in here and apply it out there?
Well, we're hoping the technology is available out there. We're just trying to see, make sure it works and it works correctly to reduce the spread of the viruses. But still, it's going to be months before it's going to be available.
One of the nicknames you have is Dr. Germ. So how disgusting are things like this phone?
Yeah, I get that nickname because we study how germs move in the environment. Where's the most contaminated surfaces? And phones are one of the worst. Most people talk dirty without realizing it all the time because they're continually putting bacteria and potentially viruses on the phone surfaces. Studies in hospitals have shown that phones can play a role in the transmission of certain diseases in hospital and healthcare situations. So we know they're involved. But what you're doing all the time without realizing, you're touching a surface, then touching your phone. So you're moving a microorganism from the surface to your phone. Now you put your phone in your pocket and you go home, and then you touch the phone again, you take the microorganisms off, and you can bring them to your face or other surfaces in your home environment.
A lot of uncertainty. What can we do to protect ourselves and minimize some of the risk we're passing along to each other?
Well, what we've seen in our studies, hand sanitizers, used routinely, disinfecting wipes, and social distancing seem to work the best. In more recent work, in looking how viruses move in the home, we found that actually bar soap and cloth towels you dry your hands with, face towels basically, can also serve ways of spreading microorganisms in the home. That's one reason you don't see bar soaps in public facilities, because they can get contaminated and one person can pick up a virus to another. We've collected several hundred towels from homes, and actually within a few days you get fecal bacteria usually growing in them, because they stay wet, they stay moist. You don't get all the bacteria on your hands when you wash your hands and they contaminate towels. So what you should do is use separate towels for individuals in the homes and change them every 2 or 3 days, and use liquid soap if you can.
We don't always get sick, so over time, do our bodies just adjust to some of these?
Well, you don't get always sick, but you're gambling with germs all the time. You have the right hygiene habits, washing your hands, you know, on a frequent basis, particularly you're out in public, and that staying home when you're ill is a thing. So you're running a germ gauntlet all the time. And the idea with using hand sanitizer, disinfecting wipes, washing your hands, is to keep the odds in your favor and not the germs' favor.
Now, you've been at the U of A for nearly 40 years. You were here for SARS, H1N1, now you're here for Corona. Are we learning something from all these illnesses?
Yeah, I think eventually we're learning something. We've had a series, you know, microorganisms don't give up. I mean, basically we're their food supply and they can evolve very rapidly. So this is kind of what's been expected. Also, the human population's growing to much larger numbers, so they're more likely for organisms to adapt and spread very rapidly through large populations like we're seeing. So this won't be the last virus that we see, and hopefully we'll be better prepared in the future.
Okay, Dr. Gerba, thank you.
Thank you.